Today, I want to show you how to use the new web-based Microsoft Planner. If you're unfamiliar with Microsoft Planner, it's a great way to connect with your other task management or project management 365 apps. It puts them all into one place, saving you a lot of time. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, when I'm showing you the new Microsoft Planner experience on the web, I'm going to be using my Microsoft 365 account. Now, I have that included in my Microsoft 365 subscription, but if you don't, I'll put a link to this down below in the description so you can access it for free. You can get Microsoft Planner for 30 days and you can add 25 users to it. And you also get access to Microsoft Project for that 30 days as well. But let's start with how to use the new Microsoft Planner. Let's start by accessing the new Microsoft Planner. You need to do this in Microsoft 365. I'm already logged into my account here. And if I go to the app launcher, you're going to see the new Planner logo right here. I can also go to all apps here. And if I scroll down a little bit, you're going to see that there is the Planner right here. So I'm going to go ahead and open this, and then I'll give you a little walkthrough and tell you why you'd want to use this. Microsoft Planner is a simple tool for organizing tasks and projects. It's easy to use. You create tasks, you assign them, set due dates, and track progress. It's visually simple to understand. They use Kanban-style boards, and you can stay on top of your work. It seamlessly integrates with Microsoft Teams, Outlook, and more. There's connected tools. So if you use Microsoft To Do, or Microsoft Project, or Microsoft Loop, all of those will feed into the new Planner. Planner is perfect for small teams or individuals who want to stay organized without overcomplicating things. Let's do a quick tour of the navigation of the new Microsoft Planner. If this side panel isn't open up, you can just simply click up here. You'll see how you can click it to expand it or collapse it. We have My Day, which will show you the private tasks that you're creating that you can check off. I'll come back to this. We have My Tasks that are going to show you all of your different tasks, whether it be private tasks or assigned to you or flagged emails. And we have My Plans. You can quickly access My Plans here. Notice up top, we have Recent, Shared, Personal, or Pinned. But if I go ahead and click on any of these, I can go to the boards to see how the planning's going. I can make changes. I can go to the schedule, to the charts. Over here, we have this one pinned. If you want to unpin anything, you can just simply click on these three little dots and go to unpin. And down at the bottom, we have a place to create our new plan, and I'll be showing you that in a bit. But we're going to start at My Day. Under My Day here, you're going to get the list of different tasks that you are to complete, to keep track, that you can just simply check off when you're done. And you'll notice that it's giving you a progress report of your task up here. Now you can make different adjustments to these. I can drop down and show if it's completed also this way, or if I'm not done something, I can, or if it's in progress, I can quickly change this. You can choose the priority the same way. If this is going to be of high importance, you can make those changes. If you have a long list, these can all be sorted as well. So sort ascending or descending. I want to point out these things can come from To Do, but it goes back and forth each way. So if I open up my To Do here, you can see of the ones I just checked off here. Or if I go over to my Microsoft Outlook, here's my to-do over here. If I go to complete it, you're going to see the ones I just checked off. So everything is synced. So whether I create them over there, they're going to come back to Planner here. Let's move over to My Task. My Task pretty much works the same as My Day, except you're going to get more tasks because these could be ones assigned to you. These could be coming from different places or flagged emails. So if I go to assign to you, wondering where this one came from? Well, if I jump over to Loop here, you can see in Loop that this was assigned from here. So this came from Loop over to My Task in here. So if I click it off here, it's going to be clicked off on the other one as well. If I go over here, it's going to show me that this is crossed out. So again, just showing you how everything is interconnected. If I go back to My Task here, we have flagged emails. I'll just open up my Outlook. If I just hover over any of these here and I give it a flag and just jump back to my other one, you're going to see that inside my planner, I have this flagged email. Again, one place to see all these things to help keep your day organized. Let's move over to my plans now. Let's take a look at my plans now. And you'll see that I have the recent list of different plans that I have. We can look at whether it be shared, personal, or pinned. Now, these can come from different places, just like I've showed you before. With this video editing one, if I go over to to-do, you'll see that it's a list inside my to-do that gets fed over to here as a plan. Now, different ones that were created inside Microsoft Teams. If you want to learn more about Planner inside Microsoft Teams, I'll put a link to that video so you can learn how to set that up there. But let's take a look at this one as an example, just to show you what you can do, and then we'll go ahead and create one from scratch. But we have our different grid view here that just kind of shows you all the different tasks. I can go through and check things off just like before. But the nice thing with this, we can go over to the Kanban style board, and this will allow you to put things into categories or different bins here. So if I want to move one over to a different bin, I could go through and do that as it moves through different phases. I can check things off here. And what's going to happen though, as I check things off here, you're going to notice that they get checked off here. I can also go to the schedule. If I want to add or create another task, I can create it from the grid. I can create it from the board here by adding another task, or I could go to the schedule and pick a date here and then just type in something. So if this is going to be, we'll say demo 3, I'll assign this to Kathy and I'll add the task. So if I go back over to my board and I'm just going to move over, you'll see that demo 3 is right here. This can be moved. This can be labeled. If I want to assign a label, labels are the different colors where I can sort through. Or if I go to the grid, here it is here. And it's just different ways to view the different tasks that you have within your plan. We also have the charts that show me what has been started, what's in progress or late or completed, that you can kind of just drill through and see what's happening in it. Before I go and start a new plan, I just want to point out I'm in dark mode right now, and I didn't mention this is just a setting inside my browser. So I'm using Microsoft Edge here. If I go to my settings and my appearance, I can change this to light mode. And you're going to notice that my plans now are, my planner is in the light mode here. And I'll continue on from here. All right, so we have new plan top right-hand corner, or we have new plan in the bottom left-hand corner. Let's go ahead and click on this and see our options. We get a couple options here. We can either create from the basic here, which I'll show you in a moment, or one of the templates will save you a little bit of time. But even from basic, it's pretty quick. So if I click on basic, and I'm going to give this a quick name, we'll just call this demo. I could add it to my pinned plans if I click here, and I can assign it to different groups. So this could be a Microsoft Teams group or a group that I have already created in here. But you can do this after also, and I'll show you how to do that. I'm going to go ahead and create this. Now it gets created, and we have our different buckets that we need to add. The difference with the templates, they're just going to have the buckets created for you, but you can still go ahead and add more. So I can click into the bucket name. So if this is going to be in progress, and I'll just add one more as an example, I can click in the next one. When I click out, I always have the spot to add the new bucket. So I can go and add my task at this point. I'm not going to go through all this because this is the same as what I showed you when I walked through my finished ones before, where we can go and change from the grid view or schedule and charts. I do want to point out with the share option up top. So if we want to go ahead and create a group, we can go and create a new group and add members to this, or we could add to the existing group. So even if you didn't assign this to a group, you can always make that adjustment later. The other thing I want to point out is if I just click on this, if you want to delete this, you can go ahead and at the bottom, it'll say delete this plan. Just click here and hit delete, and it is gone. If I click new plan one more time, I'm just going to click on see all templates here, and you'll get an idea. If I click on software development, you can see how the buckets are set up with the titles in here. So if I go ahead and use this template, I could add it to my pins, pick my group, hit create. It's going to create, and as the Kanban board opens up, you can see that I have my buckets already titled, and I have some different tasks that are already in here set up. And this can be all modified. As I zoom out, you can see software development is pinned to the side like I told it to be. A couple other things I just want to show you about Microsoft Planner and how connected it is to other Microsoft 365 apps. I'm going to open up Microsoft Teams, and I mentioned this before, I have a different video on this, but all the things that we're doing here, you can see I have Planner that's inside my Microsoft Teams, so this is a great place to use Planner. Another way you can use it is if I go over to Microsoft Loop, and I'm just going to go /, and I'll type Planner, and you can see it comes up, still has the old icon, but I can go and pick a plan from here and insert it. And if you don't know much about Microsoft Loop, this is a great place for collaboration, and they've just kind of redid the look of it. I'll have another video coming out right away explaining how to use Loop. Well, I hope you like this video about how to use the new Microsoft Planner. Hopefully you can find this useful, keeps your life organized and all the Microsoft 365. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.